One more week and you are out of here. Are you pumped? Are you primed? Are you pimped out? Are you twerked?
Twerked.
Yeah, your graduation. Awesome.
Twerked. Yeah, I guess so.
Yeah. And I'll still be around here another year. Who's going to help me with my Spanish?
Hey, Aaron. Good luck with the game tonight.
How am I ever going to pass calculus now without any help? Might as well drop out now.
Dude, Aaron, you rock, bro. Good luck at the game tonight, man.
Hey, thanks.
My homies, what's crack-a-lackin'?
Hey!
Marvin!
Woo! So we going out tonight after the game? Paint the town beige and all that?
Man, I have got a lot of finals to study for. I'll pick in.
Seriously, finals? We're seniors. This is our last week of school, and it's Friday. You are not studying tonight.
Well, I also have to get online with my League of Legends team, so.
Oh, wow. Aaron, go look at the game tonight.
Wait, there's a game tonight?
Yeah, seems like you should know that.
Seriously, we are going out tonight. That's not an option, mostly because you have a car and I don't. So you're gonna tell your League of Legends team that you can't make it tonight, champion.
I don't know.
Lord!
What?
How'd you do on that world history test?
Fairly horrible.
Way to go, Mom.
Hey, guys.
Did you know we have a game tonight?
Hey, are you going to Lydia's party after the game?
Party? Tonight? Aaron, did you hear that? Tonight. Party. Lydia's. Tonight. We are going.
Hey, Violet.
Well, hi, Aaron.
We are going to this party.
Who is Lydia?
I don't know.
She's in my homeroom. Apparently all the cool kids are going, and I've got nothing better to do. Beats staying at home. What am I going to do at home? Study for finals?
Study for finals.
Are you going to be there?
Oh, yeah. I'm going to stop by. Late. After this thing I have to do with my parents. Which means I need you to pick me up, Aaron.
I call shotgun.
Yeah, sure.
Okay, fine. Hey, it's like pulling teeth. Will you come down from whatever planet you're on? Come on, Viola, let's go. Good luck in your game tonight, Aaron.
Hey, how about a good luck Donald? Like a break a leg, or shoot a deuce, or drain one from downtown. Where's the love?
I declare that this shall be an epic evening. First we'll go pick up Ivy, and then we'll go to...
Hey.
What was her name again? Lynette?
Hey.
Violet.
No. No, the girl with the party.
Hey, guys.
Leticia?
Hey, guys.
Wanda?
Hey, I'm coming too, right? Can I have a ride?
Don't you have a game to get ready for, shooter?
Oh, man. Oh, man, look at the time!
So, Aaron, what do you think?
I think League of Legends can wait.
Yeah.
Sometimes in life, you gotta try and smell the flowers. In this life, there are nothing but possibilities.
Sure. Aaron, are you ready to go?
Yeah, I'm hungry.
Do you want to go to 7-Eleven? They have those new bugles.
Chocolate-covered peanut butter bugle balls!
Yeah.
I need those.
Oh, will you get a Slurpee?
Look, you numbskull, this is the last time. What is going on? I don't understand. We've got stuff to do. Lon! Come on, Lon, get out of there. Look, you numbskull, this is the last time. I'm tired of pulling you out of the locker every day.
It wasn't my fault. I forgot my locker combination. But when I remembered it, my biology homework was at the very back. And when I reached in, it was just so nice and so warm and so cozy.
You've got to stop going in there.
It's a magical place. There's this friendly little fawn, and I was fighting the evil white witch.
It is actually a very roomy locker.
I am surrounded by idiots. What time is it?
37.
Come on, let's go. We've only got 2 hours to prepare.
Do you think Ivy kind of digs me?
No, not at all.
Well, I'm pretty sure she does. I mean, it's not like she would... Line! That's a line!
Stupid line, Judge. What time do you think Violet's gonna be there?
What violence? Line Judge doesn't know what a line is, apparently. She's so dumb.
Violet. She said she was gonna stop by later tonight.
Man, you must really like this girl.
Yeah, so what?
So what? You're leaving in a couple of months to film school on the West Coast. You're graduating high school next week, and you're... you, and she's Violet Lucas.
What is that supposed to mean?
Man, she's Violet Lucas. She's captain of the cheerleading team. She's nice. Everybody loves her. She runs track. She competes competitively in Spanish. She's in the Latin team. And she's also on the grammar bowl, I think, if that's a thing at our school. Then she's definitely on it.
Yeah, so what? I love Mexican food. Latin's fine then, so I've seen Spartacus like 3 times.
She's rich. She's everywhere. She's popular. Do you guys have some kind of unspoken chemistry that I've never gotten to see before?
Well, I did sit behind her in chemistry class last year, so that sort of counts.
It's basically the same thing. You guys are true love. That's soulmates right there. Good job, Aaron. Besides dancing epileptically at basketball game halftime shows, what do you do? What's your brand, your image? What is the yearbook gonna say next to your name? Plays League of Legends till 2 a.m., falls asleep on the keyboard, and is part of the 5th highest ranked team in all of Central Iowa.
4th.
What?
We're ranked 4th now.
Congratulations, you did it, buddy. You hit the big time.
Look, maybe tonight'll be different. Maybe tonight's my big chance. Maybe in the yearbook it'll say, hero, warrior, loved and adored by Violet Lucas, right next to my name.
Not likely. The yearbooks went to the printers last month.
What do you want from me? I'm not studying tonight. Tonight's my big chance. I told you that. You wanted to go out, so we're going out. Show some support.
All right. Fine, Dreamweaver, let's go out. Let's make true love happen for this little boy. Safety strap, Mom makes me wear it. Come on, man, they're exactly the same. Thanks, Denise.
Bye, Mom.
You think your mom's gonna make us pancakes in the morning? Ooh, or French toast. Waffles. Those things with the toast where you crack the egg in it and then you fry it for a bit and then you flip it. Eggs on toast. No, pancakes. You think she'll make us pancakes? Her blueberry pancakes are to die for, but they're nowhere near as good as her chocolate chip pancakes that she cuts into hearts.
Oh. Dude, you seriously have a crush on my mom. That's gross.
It's not a crush, Aaron. It's a healthy appreciation. Your mom deserves a good man.
What up, gangsters, homies, peeps, players?
Any more?
That's about it.
Don't speak like that. You sound like a moron.
Hey, urban slang is becoming an increasingly valid method of social expression.
Are you really wearing your backpack?
Yeah, are you really wearing your face?
Nope, gotcha. It's a mask.
What does that even mean?
Let's just go to the party, guys.
There are books on comebacks, Donald. I bought you 2 of them now. I thought you would at least study them, try to make better comebacks, but you haven't. You failed.
I know. Just... I sent them away, but they didn't come back.
Donald.
What? Hey, wait, hey, guys, hey, wait a minute.
Don't forget, it's that Lydia.
I don't know. Ivy knows where she's at.
I'm really glad Ivy's here. It's so hot, Aaron. You don't have AC in you. Your windows are down, at least.
No! No! Just no!
What are you doing?
I'm putting my bike in your trunk.
That's what she said.
What? No! Just no! This isn't happening. Get it out.
Why are you taking your bike? Seriously?
My mom said I had to be home by 11, and I didn't want to make you guys have to leave the party early.
Get in the car, Lance Armstrong.
Cool.
Marvin, we can't...
Aaron, I'll take care of it.
Come on, Donald.
Sure.
I got it, Aaron. Lance Armstrong cheated. One job, Donald. Just show up. Aaron, you put your stuff back in your car.
Denise will take care of it. Bye, Denise.
Hey, guys. So my band's looking to play for some gigs this summer.
Your band?
Yeah, you know, some birthday parties, house parties, bar mitzvahs, ooh, illegal backyard wrestling events, whatever.
Well, don't you think you need to practice before you start playing in front of live, breathing people?
No, we practiced. We got together just last week. Well, most of us did. Robbie couldn't make it, and Max doesn't have his own set of drums, so we kind of had to...
What's your band called?
Oh, that's what we talked about most of the practice. See, we came up with some names like Phil Collins Sweat Socks and Juicebox Experience. Now Max, he likes the Bob Ross experiment, but me, I dig Space Goat.
Those are horrible band names, almost literally the worst.
Thanks, it's kind of an experimental jazz fusion thing.
Yeah, I guess the experimental part's the fact you only know about 3 chords on the guitar.
Why were you even waiting outside?
My parents are inside. Outside, I avoid the nagging.
So where is this party?
Lydia McIntyre's house. West of town, off Hemlock Road.
Wait, sorry, who? Lydia McIntosh?
McIntyre? And really? You sit right next to her in world history.
Really? I do what?
Is there gonna be a band at this party? You know, jamming, grooving.
Why is he here?
Hey, if they need a band for the party, my band can play. We are ready to rock the house, blow some chandeliers, melt some faces. I'll call Robbie now.
Oh man, do you really think that Space Goat is ready for the big time?
Sometimes I just want to punch him in the face. For reals, can I punch him in the face?
Yeah.
How about the throat?
Maybe later. Hey, I gotta make a quick stop. I need caffeine.
So, Ivy, this is a real big night for our little boy Aaron here.
Oh yeah, so we gonna roll a 77 while maintaining an invisible force field over the land of Nod?
The reference, but no, he is actually going to be professing his undying love for, wait for it, Violet Lucas.
Shut up!
Yeah, sure, just like the time he was going to confess his undying love to Patty DeVroe freshman year. And the whole year went by without him saying one word to her. Or that time when he wanted to profess his undying love to Olivia Rodriguez in the
Olivia.
Seventh grade. And eventually, she moved back to El Salvador without him saying one word to her either.
Well, tonight's gonna be different.
Ooh, or that time when he was gonna profess his undying love to Samantha Stetson.
Oh, come on. I was like 10 years old and she was my math teacher. That doesn't even count.
She was pretty.
Okay, Rico Suave, what's so different about tonight?
Well, in the immortal words of Jim Morrison, The time to hesitate is through.
Well, that's poetic and all, but I really think that you should probably...
I know what you're talking about there, Aaron. Life is short. Opportunities are nigh. Sometimes you just gotta grab life by the lips and yank!
Yeah, what Donald said. Tonight, my assault on the world begins.
Look out, world.
I'll be back in a sec. I'm gonna go refuel for the mission.
And I'm gonna grab some bugles.
Okay, fine. Just leave me alone in the car with Donald. We'll play Spin the Bottle. It'll be great.
I didn't bring a bottle. Oh, wait a second. I got this. Will this work? I'll go first.
Hey, Aaron, look, I thought I smelt something. It's our good friend Jake Mahoney. Oh, and he brought his girlfriend, Joel. Hey, Joel.
What are you two losers doing here? Is it halftime at your World of Warcraft game? Decide to get out of your mommy's basement and see the sun?
Oh, absolutely, Jake. You've busted us. We come out once a week just so we can get a 5-pound bag of Cheetos to go along with the case of Mountain Dew I've got in the trunk.
Dude, I would love it if you had a case of Mountain Dew in your trunk.
Is this your big Dungeons & Dragons night? Is your Dungeon Master waiting in your car? You gonna roll your D12 and stock up on some XP?
What?
You heard him.
Yeah, you gonna walk into a gelatinous cube and melt into a big puddle of boo-hoo mama tear?
Wow, Jake, you actually know quite a bit about Dungeons & Dragons.
Yeah, well, your mom knows. And your face is... Shut up.
It's okay. You're among friends, Jake. Acceptance is the first part of the process.
Whatever, man.
Yeah, whatever, man.
Did she seriously date him last year?
He is a very handsome man, Aaron.
Well, it couldn't have been that serious. What could she possibly see in him?
Yep, you're right, Aaron. He is absolutely hideous. I mean, what could he possibly give her that you can't?
Didn't he actually fail home ec?
Yep.
How's that even possible?
Says the man that barely scraped by with a D last year in gym.
Whatever, that's totally different. Hey, look, they got buffalo blue cheese pretzel combos.
You know what, Aaron? I will make you a deal. I will buy those combos and devour them the minute Jake decides to play D&D with us.
Losers, who even eats bugles anyways?
I'm sorry, do you work here or something? What are you guys doing here? Are you on a smoke break?
Well, you two dorks, go back to your basement. We're gonna go hit up some parties and scope out the honeys.
Scope some honeys?
Yeah, some honeys, you nimrods.
You know what, listen, if you guys know so much about women, then what?
Critical fail, Marvin. I don't care what you roll on your D20, you're gonna die.
Listen, Jake, it was an accident.
Get him, Jake.
Would it help if I gave you some bugles? Hey, Aaron?
Yeah?
Run! Run!
Yep, just checking your oil.
Get in the car, Donald!
Now you're in a hurry?
Places to do, stuff to things, and go, go, go!
Stop the car, Aaron.
Hey, did anybody get me a Slurpee? I really wanted a Slurpee. And a Slim Jim.
Nobody cares about your Slim Jim, Donald.
Hi, can I take your order?
Are you really running like a little girl? I'll find you, freak. And you can't roll your way out of this one.
I'm sorry, we're all out of that. Would you like something from the dessert menu?
What did you do to make Einstein so angry? Why are his pants wet?
I think you just answered your own question.
Bye, Jake.
Twice!
Well, I'm glad we all handled that as mature adults.
Did Jake need a ride? We've got plenty of room back here.
Yeah, maybe you can sit on his lap.
Well, it's not that big of a deal, right? I mean, surely he's not going to hold a grudge against us about that.
No, I'm sure he was perfectly okay with it. In fact, I bet this won't even come up again in the future.
What on earth is playing? What is this?
My band's demo tape. Like it?
No!
This is music? Oh, rock and roll's been going downhill ever since Kurt Cobain died.
No, I am not gonna start calling you Tumna.
Come on, please! Just for this one night.
Do you guys smell that? That is the smell of a night ripe with potential.
That, my dear Lydia, is car exhaust and hot dogs that have been on the burner since this morning. Our lawn forgot his axe deodorant again. Okay, so what all do we need?
Oh, I got it right here. I just downloaded the list off LimeWire. Come on in close.
I got all our supplies right here.
Check it out. Here it is. We need a 64-ounce bottle of mustard, one roll of chicken wire, ponchos, lime green, and high-grade aluminum foil.
Wait, you downloaded the manual off LimeWire?
Mm-hmm. I've already got 8.5 pounds of grade 2 fertilizer straight from my neighbor's poodle. What? I've actually been saving it for months. It's in the trunk.
Ooh. Well, that may account for the part of that ripe smell.
And spam, a whole crate of spam.
Where are we going to find a crate of spam?
We can't just get that here.
Do you think a small gas station convenience store is going to carry whole crates of spam? Whatever, let's get started.
Do you even know where you're going?
No.
Lydia McIntyre's house, west of town, off Hemlock Road? How difficult is that? Battery's dead in your brain's GPS?
I really, really wanted some bugles. You think we can stop somewhere else?
Her house is just down the street from my church.
You own a church?
I bet there's going to be food at the party, you guys. I was at this party one time, and they had like this enormous spread of food. It was like a 12-course meal. We had lobster and champagne, the whole deal.
When were you at a party with lobster and champagne?
Well, I wasn't there per se.
Not.
But it was like I was there. Saw it on TV. It was like PBS or Discovery Channel or something.
Hey, shooter. Back at the gas station, did you remember to set the latch when you shut the hood?
Well, what do you think? Maybe. Probably.
Yeah, probably?
Ah!
exciting.
Looking for this?
Yep.
So what we do see is we boost Lydia up to the roof using the AC unit and the side gutters for leverage. Once she gets up there, she moves across to the ventilation shaft on the east, maybe east, northeast of, you know, the roof. Then she radios down to us. Did you bring the talkie-walkies? And then... Are you guys paying attention? Huh?
Yeah, got it. Or you just use the key. I grabbed it off my dad's dresser.
Okay, I think we're almost there, like a few blocks away. Oh man, I really need to get cleaned up.
Here?
Works for me. I mean, I'm sorry, Princess Fiona. Are your standards too high for this blue-collar establishment?
Hey guys, I'm pretty sweaty too. I could use a, you know, hose off.
You guys do realize that this is a car wash, right?
Yeah, Ivy, wash. Car washes have water. I don't see what the problem is here. It's been a long time since my last car wash bath, Aaron.
Oh, man. Good. I hope they have the nice colored studs.
Oh, the colored studs.
The
really?
Pink ones are the best.
Hey, Marv.
What's up, dude?
Got some quarters?
Yeah. Separate prices, my friend.
Ooh, good catch. Yeah, thanks.
I can't believe this is happening right now.
Ooh. Hey guys, I brought some soap.
Wow. I'm not even gonna ask why you have soap in your backpack.
Tri-gloss breaks me out.
Yeah, it does me too. Under the armpits, especially, the
most
sensitive area.
It is, yeah.
I can't, seriously, a roll? You carry around a roll of quarters.
My dad gave it to me in case we needed money.
Hey, Aaron. A word, please.
All right, do you want to go first or do you want to, I'll take the ball. I'll go first.
Sure.
What's up?
Look, we don't have to go to this party, you know.
Wait. What? Why would you say that?
Well, I don't know. That tonight's been kind of weird. I mean, it's like the universe is telling us, or your car is telling us, that we should, I don't know, go home. I mean, we could watch Troll 2 again, or Master of the Flying Guillotine, or I've just got this bootleg of the Toxic Avenger, the musical. It's Toxic Avenger plus song.
This was your idea in the first place.
Yeah, I know.
Tonight was the night. I was gonna tell Violet that...
See, that's the thing, Aaron. Are you sure you want to do that?
Well, I was 3 hours ago.
Look, it's not that I don't think you can get Violet. It's... I mean, you're a great guy. I don't know. You're you, and she's...
Oh, come on. That's the second time I've heard that tonight. How do I not take that personally?
No, it's not you. It's just...
Hey, guys. How do I look? I feel like I'm straight out of a Mentos commercial. Fresh and delicious. A little minty.
You look great. Look, I need to go hose off, and then we're going to this party. When I get back, we're going to the party. Before I lose whatever nerve I actually have left. Come on.
Wow. What did you do, Grouchy Gretchen?
I may have suggested that instead of going to the party, we go home and watch movies or something. I could Dungeon Master for you guys again. That was pretty fun.
How dare you? How dare you, Ivy?
This is the first time he's actually wanted to do something fun in who knows how long. And not to mention when he's in leading man romantic comedy mode.
Oh, come on! You tried to talk him out of the whole Violet thing back at his house!
Well, yeah, but I'm supposed to. I'm his best friend. Besides, the best friend is supposed to be skeptical at the beginning and fully supportive by the end. It's kind of a literary device, Ivy.
Well, haven't you mastered the supporting character role?
Yes. Besides, you never know. Maybe you will find somebody at this party. Maybe I'll find somebody at this party.
Yeah, like that'll happen. Like anybody's gonna fall in love with the girl who's hanging out with Larry, Moe, and Curly. Well, look, if I'm going to go meet Lloyd Dobler tonight, I guess I better go get cleaned up.
You know, Ivy, I've always thought of us as more of a Groucho, Harpo, and Chico trio. And you're our Margaret Dumont.
Aaron, can we get this door fixed?
Come on, guys, let's go. Let's get busy into his house.
Please, please tell me I'm not gonna have to babysit him all night.
Yeah, he's all yours. Don't forget, his mom wants him home by 11.
Ivy Smith? Oh, my sweet latte, come over here. Oh my gosh, how have you been?
Have fun with that.
Ron Adams, what's up, man? What are you doing here?
Oh, you know, just living the dream.
Dude, you rocked at that game earlier. So, do you know Lydia then?
Oh?
No, not really.
Hey, dude, didn't you get into USC's film school?
Hey, Chip, who told you that?
Mr. Mellon, I've come for media and communications.
Oh, yeah, well, yeah, I did.
So does that mean like you'll be making movies for reals? Like with Wesley Snipes and Jean-Claude Van Damme? Oh, what about Dolph Lundgren?
Dolph Lundgren? Like Ivan Drago?
I must break you.
Yeah, well, that means you'll get to hang out with like Rutger Hauer, Seagal.
Maybe I'll have to check their availability.
Man, you are so living the dream. I love those guys!
So me and the rest of the yearbook staff were there until midnight trying to get it finished.
Yeah, that's totally fascinating.
Maria, like I was telling you, Ivy and I were total BFFs back in middle school. Remember passing notes in Mr. Howard's social studies class? Good times, right?
Uh-huh.
Man, that guy was such a prick. I think I had detention every week for a year.
Well, that was the golden age of our youth.
And we'd listen to Tom Jones in my bedroom and have sleepovers and practice kissing my Scott Baio poster.
Okay, wait just a minute. You had a Scott Baio poster?
Have.
You have a Scott Baio poster?
Goodness. Well, this has been a wonderful, magical trip down memory lane, ladies, but I think I'm gonna go inside and get some fresh air.
It was great to catch up!
Bye!
So do you seriously have a Scott Baio poster in your bedroom?
Hey guys, wanna hear my band's new demo tape? It's really awesome.
Buzz off.
You sure? Okay, maybe later, okay? Hey guys, wanna hear my band's demo tape? You're gonna love it.
That's okay, not right now.
Oh, not right now, maybe later, right?
Sure,
cool, alright, yeah.
Well, if it isn't Donald Farmington.
Hey, guys.
How's it going, Juliet? All right, cool.
What are you doing?
Hey, my band's got this demo tape.
And I bet you want me to listen to it.
Well, actually, I wanted Juliet to listen to it.
Oh. And you don't want me to listen to it?
Well, I guess.
Here, give it here. Let's see what you got.
It's really cool. How you like it, yeah.
What is he doing?
Hey, you're back! You wanna listen to my...
No.
Get it for you.
Back. It looks like you found yourself one fan.
Yeah.
Of course I've seen Kickboxer. Who hasn't seen Kickboxer?
I've got the soundtrack on vinyl.
Oh, that is wicked awesome!
I really don't know if that's the style of film I'll be
making. Caged Heat!
Huh?
Caged Heat! That's the 70s Jonathan Demme flick that we were talking about earlier, but we couldn't remember the name of it.
Barbara Steele. Great film. Really pushed feminism into the stream of social consciousness.
Ha! You hear that, Adams? Maybe Marv here should be the one going to movie college.
Yeah. I'm more of a community college kind of guy, you know? Aaron is really the artiste when it comes to this kind of stuff. You should see the stuff he's put together. It's fantastic.
Thanks. I'm gonna go grab a drink.
You had one. It was about a baby sparrow. Fell from the nest. It was beautiful. Black and white. HD resolution the entire time. I held the boom when the baby sparrow fell.
Done reliving the golden years with Emily and what's-her-face over there?
Shut up. I don't even know why I wanted to come here.
Well, if you're interested in deep philosophical discussions about 70s exploitation cinema, feel free to join James Lipton and Siskel and Ebert over there.
They're talking about movies and you're not interested?
Eh.
I've been meaning to talk to you about that, you know.
About what?
Film school, USC. Oh, look, I know it's cool you got in. It's just,
Just what?
It's the University of Southern California, Aaron. Southern California.
No.
Let me put it this way. Despite your hair, you are a Dubuque kind of guy, not an LA kind of guy.
I feel like I should be offended by that.
Look, Stephanie Steele over there, she's a Southern California type person. Or Brad Warner over there, he's a California type person. Maybe Northern California.
Give me a break. I visited the campus last fall. I fit in somewhat.
You said everyone looked like a supermodel or a hipster Quentin Tarantino.
Fine, you've got me, okay? I'm not gonna fit in. It's gonna be a disaster. I'm gonna get there on the first day of classes, and everybody's gonna know I have no business being there. This was the night I was supposed to get my confidence back.
Stop it. I didn't mean to...
Hey guys, guess what? Guess what? Am I interrupting something? Anyway, our band got a gig. Sweet.
Space Goat got a gig.
Yeah, Romeo's brother has a friend whose uncle manages a place called Cooper's in Kansas City, and apparently their opening act canceled.
Cooper's, Kansas City.
Yeah.
The famous nightclub.
Yeah, you've heard of it? Anyway, there's some kind of show there, and the opening act had to cancel because the drummer and the bass player got injured in a hot air balloon accident.
You're not seriously talking about Cooper's, the famous nightclub in downtown Kansas City? Where Joe Bonamassa and the North Mississippi All-Stars played last month? That Cooper's?
Yeah, that's what I said. Except I don't know who Joe Mississippi is or whoever you just mentioned, but anyway, we're opening there tomorrow night.
We really gotta get a name for that band.
Honestly, Space Goat's starting to grow on me.
Who are you opening for?
Someone I've never heard of.
Who is it?
Let me see. Ted S. Key Trucks, maybe?
The Tedeschi Trucks Band?
No.
Shut up!
Ow!
You are not seriously opening for Susan Tedeschi and Derek Trucks tomorrow. You are lying.
What'd you hit me for? No, S. Maria. Apparently they really needed someone.
I am coming with you. I'll be your roadie. I will carry your stupid crappy guitar. I don't care. I'm coming.
Wow, Donald. That's really cool. I don't even know what to say.
Yeah, thanks. Well, I gotta call Robbie and Max.
I don't know whether to be annoyed or impressed.
Hey, dork. Where's your friend?
Yeah, your soon-to-be pummeled friend.
Hey there, Jake. You still out there scoping for some honeys?
Funny. Where's your orc buddy?
I do not know what you speak of. I doth have no friends.
Hey now, children, let's play nicely. It's a lovely Friday night. We're about to be certifiable adults. You're going to graduate next week, right, Jake? There's absolutely no need to resort to any of this ultra violence, right?
I'm not stupid. I know what movie boy here is trying to do. He's trying to make me the stereotypical big, bad, dumb, bad guy in what he thinks is some high school movie. Trying to turn me into the Chet Donnelly or the John Bender.
Oh, come on. John Bender was never the bad guy. If anything, he was the protagonist. Mr. Vernon.
Lost. I thought we was looking for Marvin.
Never mind. I'll find him myself.
Jeez, what's the deal? Marv took off like a bat out of hell.
Ah, Meatloaf. Great album.
Well, there may have been an incident earlier in the evening involving Marv, a quick stop soda, and Jake's pants.
That's hilarious.
Hey, has anybody seen Lydia? Huh? Lydia.
What?
Who?
Lydia.
Lydia.
This is her house.
Lydia, get over here.
What?
Did you bring in the mustard?
Lon said he was carrying the mustard. I got this stuff.
Lon? Where is he?
I think he was headed toward his locker.
Oh, come on. Again? Seriously?
He said Lucy and Edmund needed him.
Oh, seriously. Oh, gosh.
What?
I'm just trying to figure out how I got to be the king of the dimwits.
We had an election.
Well, fine. I'll just get in myself. Here. Go ahead and get started.
Whatever. I don't know what his rush is. I don't have anywhere else to be.
Yeah. So, he actually was looking at our family photos. And the look on his face, it was disturbing.
That's gross.
I know.
That's gross.
I need to talk to
him. That's gross. Ew.
Guys, is that meathead gone yet?
You are such a baby.
You know what, Ivy? Maybe I don't have somebody to protect me every day, but I wish I... Oh, crap!
Think we should do something about that?
No.
Did I just see Donald Farmington screaming and doing backflips in the yard?
Yeah, Shooter's a little excited about his gig.
His
Why do they call him Shooter?
Well, have you seen the movie Hoosiers?
Yeah.
Are you familiar with the Dennis Hopper character?
Yeah.
Donald's father is a raging alcoholic. Took us all by surprise. It's a real dark Thursday.
We're just joking. He's just really bad at basketball.
Really bad at basketball.
And baseball.
In comparison.
So, when's Violet gonna get here?
Violet Lucas?
Yes.
Oh, I figured she'd be with her dad all night. He flew into town for some award thing, right?
What are you talking about?
She said she'd be by afterward.
Any idea when that'll be?
Those award shows run pretty late, man. Plus, I'm sure I'll have plenty of interviews to do afterwards.
Oh. Interviews? What's the award for?
Some lifetime achievement thing.
Wait, what? Who's her father?
You're joking, right? Oh my gosh, you're not joking.
What? Somebody fill me in here. I feel like I'm missing something.
So all this time, you have been proclaiming your undying love for Violet Lucas, and you do not know who her father is?
Mr. Lucas? I don't know. Is he like a police officer, a mobster? Oh no. Is he a politician?
I have been reading this entire situation completely wrong.
All right. Somebody has got to fill me in. I deeply apologize for my lack of wisdom concerning the genealogy of my classmates.
George Lucas, Aaron. George Lucas.
George Lucas, Star Wars, George Lucas, Indiana Jones, George Lucas, Lucasfilm, George Lucas.
Mm-hmm. American Graffiti.
THX 1138.
Industrial Light and Magic.
USC Film School grad and benefactor.
Oh, wow. How has this never come up before?
Well, other than the fact that it's common knowledge, I thought you would have seen him at school events at some point. Violet says he's been to a few choir concerts and track meets.
Oh, come on. You've been to about as many choir concerts and track meets as I've been.
Fair point.
Oh, I think I'm gonna be sick. Oh.
What's going on?
Aaron didn't know who Violet Lucas's father was.
Seriously? Aren't you like a film buff or something?
Hey, do you guys know that Jake is outside looking for Marvin? He was just yelling, "Smoke up, Johnny!" Hey, what's wrong with Aaron? You got the squirts again?
Oh.
Here, breathe into this and calm down.
Oh, this is bad. Do they have a bathroom around here? I need some air.
Aaron.
I'll be back.
Aaron, are you sure you're...
Yeah. Oh my
God. You can't run forever.
I was really hoping to. Just... OK,
Okay, okay, okay. Here's the idea. Then we'll roll for it. If you win, you get to pummel me in the backyard and throw me in the pool and impress all the honeys and make me look like the bad guy. You get to be the hero, and if I win, you have to play D&D with me next weekend.
One roll. No saving throws.
I'll start this journey from where it began. A host too many, but too few a friend. Light on my feet, I maneuver critiques and place them in places I can't see. And I learned to break bread with the ghosts from my past. They wrote that scene and they played on the cast. They said so long since I've seen you last. How did you make it back?
Am I interrupting your big, thoughtful, pensive moments alone? Ever think life would be this complicated back when we were kids?
What do you mean?
We used to spend our time riding big wheels in the cul-de-sac behind your house, or riding roller skates in my mom's basement. Remember that time when you and me and Emily and Marvin all were riding bikes by the creek and you fell in?
Yeah. You started crying? And then Marvin had to fish me out of the water.
Life was more simple back then, you know?
No kidding. What happened?
Well, puberty for one.
Yeah, there's that. Plus impending adulthood.
Yeah, that. What a crock of crap to look forward to. I didn't mean to freak you out earlier.
It's okay.
You're gonna be fine. I'm just a bit annoyed you're leaving.
What do you mean? You're leaving too.
Please, it's Iowa State. It's like an hour away. I could commute if I wanted to.
The way you drive, I wouldn't recommend it. We figured out what you're gonna study yet.
Forever undeclared.
Well, if it helps, I've heard that your BFF Emily is gonna be going there too.
Great. You know, you could just straight up tell Violet that you like her. Stop making it into this, like, big thing.
Well, let's see. If she finds out that I'm going to USC and I'm studying film, what do you think she's going to think my motives are?
That's true.
You think it would be so cool that he's her dad? To have the possibility of that kind of contact in the industry, right?
Right.
Well, it's not. Honestly, it just complicates things. It just makes me look like some desperate guy working on an angle, you know?
This was definitely not a problem when we dated.
That was eighth grade, and it was for like a month. I don't even think that counts as dating.
I thought it was hilarious that my mom wanted to take you to take your kid to work day instead of me that year. She loved you.
What can I say? Moms love me. Your mom's not so bad, by the way.
What?
My mom. I know it gets bad at home sometimes, but you gotta give her a break. It's been pretty rough since your dad left.
Yeah. See? We never used to have these deep, pensive conversations when we were playing cops and robbers and freeze tag.
You're it.
Look, you should just talk to Violet. Whether it's tonight, if she comes, or tomorrow, or next week. Stop making things so complicated. Stop being all brooding and introspective, and man up and tell her. You're a good guy, she knows that. Well, she probably knows that. And for the right price, I'd put in a good word for you. I'd be willing to take those Weezer concert tickets off your hands in exchange for telling her you're not a creepy psychopath stalker.
Carlos the Dwarf is a fantastic character name. I would adventure to the deepest depths of the Dragon Guard. Oh, hey, Aaron.
Everything copacetic here?
Yeah, of course. Hey, do you mind if Jake maybe joins us for some D&D next weekend?
Yeah, I can bring some chips or something if that's okay with you guys.
Chips.
Wow, okay, that's new.
Hey everybody, I wanted to announce that the Drama Club is having auditions next week for the Prairie City Summer Musical.
Oh boy, wonder what they're doing this year. Springtime for Hitler.
Oh, very funny. And for your information, we'll be putting on the breathtaking performance.
You know what would be awesome? If they made more action movies in that, like, musicals.
Die Hard, the musical.
John McClane sings and dances his way into your heart.
Yes, I would be the first in line to see that. Hair.
What?
Like a rabbit?
Ugh, no, you idiots. Hair, the musical.
Doesn't that have a big nude scene? Like where everybody gets naked?
Yes, and it'll be done very tastefully.
Everybody gets naked? All right.
Don't be so immature. The human body is a beautiful thing. It's all about freedom.
Do you think this is a beautiful thing? Because if so, sign me up.
Okay, yeah. There'll be plenty of parts to go around, and of course, anyone is encouraged to audition. And...
is the Drama Club seriously going to try and do another musical? Didn't you learn your lesson last year?
Yeah, last year was an unfortunate turn of events that we do not expect to happen again this year.
You mean the dance number pileup that sent four of your cast members and three people from the audience to the hospital?
Yeah, we're hiring a professional choreographer.
Yeah, she's from Lithuania or something Slavish. She had a part as a dancer in a little Bow Wow video back in 1990.
Good evening, ma'am. I'm Deputy Collins with the Sheriff's Office. Are you the homeowner?
No.
Well, listen, we've had some reports of some loud music and maybe some underage drinking here. You mind if I come in and look around a little bit?
Fine with me. It's not my house. This is root beer.
Okay.
Oh, man, it's the fuzz.
Oh, sweet! Is it rigged or is he more of a Murtaugh?
I'm getting too old for this shit. So I don't suppose either one of you guys are the homeowners, are you?
No, sir. No, sir.
Not me.
You and your boys been drinking?
No. Sparkling lemonade.
Just a little bit of tea and honey.
All right. Carry on. Jake Mahoney, what's up, big man? I know, your dad. You been drinking?
Nope. Green chai tea.
Really? Green chai tea?
It's high in antioxidants.
That's important. Yeah.
Well, what about you?
Red Bull.
So nobody here's been drinking?
Of course not.
That's really surprising. So listen up, I just need to know who the homeowner is.
That would be Lydia McIntyre. Real nice girl. She's actually in my world history class.
Yeah, actually I haven't seen her all night. Wonder where she is.
What's up? How you doing? I'm a hot boy! What's up?
Oh my.
Oh no.
Well, would you look at that? What you been drinking there, son?
Just a little.
Just a little what? Whew. So what's your name?
Happy birthday to Donald.
Donald, how old are you, bub?
17.
All right, listen up. I'm going to take you in, all right? And I'm going to call your parents, all right?
Oh, man, right. Please, don't call my parents. No, please. No. Wait. What time is it?
I don't know, like 2:30?
Oh, man, I was supposed to be home by 11.
Can you start the call?
Miss Collins, go ahead.
Hey, Collins, you still out on the west side?
It's affirmative.
Yeah, we got reports of a disturbance, maybe a break-in over at the high school. Can you get over there and check it out?
I'll be in route. Listen, Bo, it's your lucky day, man. All right, so listen. Don't drink. Don't do drugs. And make good life choices, all right?
Oh, yes, sir. If ever given the opportunity, I'm going to make a good choice. You have my oath of honor. You have my honor.
Listen, don't even think about driving home tonight, all right?
Yes, sir. Can I ride my bike?
I'll see you. All right. Good night.
You smell like cheap potato vodka. Gross.
Oh man, that was rad. Did you see that? I thought Donald was going to the slammer for sure.
The big house.
The joints, scared straight, come to life.
Seriously, Donald, what were you thinking? First of all, your mother would totally be mad at you. She'd kill you. Second of all, you'd get kicked off the basketball team for sure.
Aaron.
I mean, seriously, what do you think you are? Dean Martin now or something?
Hey, guys. What's going on? There was a cop out front.
Violet. Hi.
Well, hi, Aaron. So what'd I miss?
Well, let's see. An existential crisis, the breakdown of cliquish walls, the rise and fall of... nothing much. How was the, award thing?
Boring, but took forever. And my dad already caught a flight back to the ranch. So, what's going on?
You okay?
Yeah, that's better.
Oh, Violet. Can I get you something to drink? Like a Red Bull or a green chai tea?
Is that some sort of new mixer? Red Bull and green chai tea? Just a Coke or something would be fine. So, did it just get awkward because I got here, or has it been weird like this all night?
Ow! So, Violet. Hi, you wanna, how's it going?
How's what going?
You know, life, things.
It's good, I guess. So what's going on? Are you sick or something? Do you need to go to the bathroom?
Look, all right, Violet. It's like this. I like you. I like you a lot. I've liked you for a really long time. I think you're beautiful. I think you're funny. You're sweet. You're nice. Violet, I want to go out for coffee with you and hear you talk about your day. I want to go on walks on the beach and hear you talk about your hopes and dreams. Violet, you captivate me. You invade my soul.
Damn.
Sorry.
Wow. That was very sweet and interesting.
Let me say this. I'm scared to say anything because of what you might think. I'm scared you're going to think it's about your father and me and USC and film school. I'm scared that you're going to be annoyed that it took me this long to say anything. Mostly, I'm just scared to graduate and to leave town and not tell you how I really feel.
Wow. Okay, maybe we should have had this conversation somewhere more private.
Oh, that was a good moment.
That was really sweet, Aaron.
But,
oh, I don't know. I like you too. Why did you wait so long to say anything?
Fear? Complacency? Fear. Yeah, I'm going with fear.
I don't know. It's just that after graduation, I'm headed to California for an internship for the summer.
Oh. That's great. It sounds like fun.
So you know, it's complicated. I don't want to start something and then be gone for months.
Complicated. Yeah, I get it.
Yeah. But we'll see each other in the fall, so who knows?
Yeah, wait, what?
In the fall at USC.
What? At USC?
Yes, Aaron. I'm going to USC in the fall to study architecture.
How did I not know that?
I have no idea. You really need to get out more.
Yeah, I do. Hey, that's great! Because I'm going to USC in the fall.
Yes, Aaron, I know.
Oh, hey, there's that thing I dropped.
Hey, did you know Violet's going to USC in the fall?
Yeah, did you not know that?
No, how come nobody tells me these things?
Well, Aaron, you know, it was on the announcements last week. She got a scholarship and everything. Congratulations, by the way.
Thank you.
Sure, the Pixies? Yeah, I saw them last year at Cedar Rapids. Surfer Rosa, that's my favorite album of all time.
Are you serious? I love the Pixies.
I got most of their stuff on vinyl. You should come over and listen sometime.
Vinyl? Oh. That's really cool.
The Athena Women's Scholarship for founding women's around the world.
I didn't know you were Greek.
Hey, I just really clogged the toilet upstairs.
Oh,
have
God.
You seen Lydia?
You know, I have not seen her at all tonight.
Whoever that is, she is missing out on one heck of a party.
Come on, you jokesters.
Yup, my old man is gonna kill me.
So, do we, like, get a phone call, or do we have the right to remain silent?
You've been watching way too much TV.
To the glistening eastern sea, I give you Queen Lucy, the valiant. To the great western wood, I give you King Edmund, the just. And to the radiant southern sea, I give you Queen Susan, the babe.
What is his problem?
Can you please take the cuffs off for just a minute so I can punch him in the face?
Oh, hey, can we stop by my house real quick? I just remembered people were coming over.
This restaurant is pretty tasty.
Have you?
I can't believe you didn't know that Violet was going to USC. You really need to start paying attention.
Yeah, that's what I've been told.
So, I'm thinking about being an Eladrin with high dexterity and intelligence.
You know, I always end up being a streetwise elf. It fits my personality. High thievery.
Do you guys mind holding it down just a bit?
So, are you going to KC tonight or not?
My mom said I could still go to the concert, but she's gonna come with me. And she's taking me home right after it's over.
Well, that's the least rock and roll thing I've ever heard in my life.
You know what I think? I think life is a lot less complicated than we make it out to be.
You think so?
Yeah, sure, we're young. We got our whole lives ahead of us. Jobs, careers, families, kids. Those are the complicated parts of life.
Speak for yourself. You know, I do have a job. I'm gonna be out in this heat mowing lawns 40 hours a week all summer.
So it's not so complicated? Well, tell me something, Avril Lavigne. What you gonna do about all those college loans when you graduate?
I'd rather not talk about that.
So Jake, what are you doing after you graduate?
I'm gonna work construction all summer and then head off to Iowa State in the fall.
Wait, you're going to Iowa State?
Yeah, a wrestling scholarship.
Well, that's interesting.
Thank you, everyone, for reminding me how I'm going to be stuck here all by myself next year. Probably failing every class I take.
Come on, man. You got Robbie and Max back here with you. I mean, not to mention Space Goat's gonna keep you occupied on tour like 9 months out of the year.
Very funny.
Big time. Hey, can you do me a favor, man? When you guys make it big, can you remember me for your first music video? I'm thinking something animated with like explosions and talking cats.
Guys, go watch that video.
You guys are so hilarious.
Well,
I'm going home.
Need a ride?
Nope. I'll walk. It's not far. Maybe the air will do my head some good.
Are you, you gonna finish that? Yoink.
Hey, Aaron, I just wanted to tell you good luck with Violet. She's a great girl.
Yeah, thanks. If you don't mind me asking, didn't you guys date for a little bit last year?
Yeah, for a little bit. Just, weren't compatible.
Not compatible?
Man, you should see her Netflix queue. It's all this reality show and dating my 600-pound tumor. No.
I love that one. I've seen that one. I told you about that one. But Nelly? Annie Libby?
I think if that's the worst of it, I could probably deal with it. Maybe.
I gotta head out. I gotta hit the gym and go grocery shop for my mom.
Hey, can I grab a ride home?
Yeah, sure. Hey, we're meeting tomorrow at Mars.
Yeah.
See you there. Who would have thought that would happen 24 hours ago?
Yeah, I know. My mind's having a hard time comprehending all the odd and surprising things right there.
Some things with you and Violet.
Yeah.
In this world, there are nothing but possibilities.
What?
You said that yesterday at school.
I did? It must have been a line from a movie. I do that a lot.
Yeah.
You know, I'm gonna miss this.
Miss what?
Hanging out. Playing D&D, talking, watching movies. shooting pool in your barn and eating cheap pizza till 2 a.m. in the morning?
Yeah, well, you know, I'm going to be around anytime you come back this fall, probably playing pool and eating cheap pizza until 2 a.m. So whenever you're here, stop on by.
I will. And hey, we've got all summer, right? I mean, if we wanted to, we could go out every night and scope for some honeys.
You bet.
To graduation. Real life. Wonderfully complicated real life.
You know what? Forget real life. I fully expect us to be watching terrible movies and playing video games in our basements until we're 40.
It's a date. All right, let's get out of here. I'm tired. My bed awaits. Oh. Before we go, eat up, man.
You know, I doubt they're that bad. Aaron, hurry up.
Go back and do that. Do the what are you doing?
Shoot the ball!
Scene 4 takes a good.
let me take you back to paradise. All you gotta do is close your eyes. And the fall of the desire, move our toes up to the
front. This is scene 3, shot 6, take 1.
Hashtag flawless.